Hi, today we're going to be showing you how to OAD a custom image onto your LPSTK. So the first thing we're going to do is create the custom image that we'll load onto our LPSTK device. To do that, we can use any IDE. We can use Code Composer Studio, a third-party IDE, or in this case, I'm going to be using CCS Cloud. So to get a project into CCS Cloud, the first thing I'll do is go to dev.ti.com and open up Resource Explorer and pick the example I want to modify. In this case, I'm going to be using the DMM sensor example for the LPSTK, making a few modifications to it. So within dev.ti.com/tirex, I'll select the image that I'm interested in. I'll click import, and that'll bring it into CCS Cloud. At this point, I can make any modifications I want to it, and when I'm done, all I do is click the hammer button to build. Once this is done building, it's going to generate a couple different things. The thing we're interested in is the .bin file, and you'll be able to see that in your workspace. In order to get that .bin file onto our mobile device to OAD, there's a couple ways we can do that. We can either download the file locally to our computer and send it to ourselves over email or a file sharing service like Dropbox, or we can open up our CCS Cloud workspace on our mobile device and download it locally. And so what I've done is I've already emailed it to myself and it's in my downloads. So what I'm going to do is copy it into the SimpleLink Starter app folder on my iPad, which you can see here. At this point, I can open up the SimpleLink Starter app and you'll see the list of BLE devices show up there. I'm going to select multi-sensor. And now I'm able to enter firmware download. At this point, you'll see the select firmware file button. I'll click that. At the top of the screen, you'll see the pre-compiled images for your LPSTK. What I'm going to do is click on uploaded images, and these are the images that I've loaded onto my mobile device. You can see the .bin there. I'm going to just click it and click program. At this point, we'll see the OAD happen, and we'll load the new binary image onto our LPSTK. All right, and now that our OAD is complete, I'll click OK. And now a kind of best practice is to go into the settings on your mobile device, turn Bluetooth off and then back on. And what that's going to do is just clear any cache on your device. Since we have an entirely new image on our LPSTK, we want to make sure the device recognizes that. So now when I open up the SimpleLink Starter app, you'll see that it's now a 15.4 DMM example. At this point, we can use the provisioning interface to provision the device to connect to a 15.4 network. And that's it. So this can be done with any custom image as long as it's OAD enabled. And there's multiple ways to get these binaries onto your mobile device. If you want to learn more, you can go to dev.ti.com/LPSTK.